every officer recognizes that it could be them. It could be them today. It could be them tonight or tomorrow.
Now at 6, the sobering process of saying goodbye to a fallen Indiana deputy and the somber commitment to standing by his family when they need it the most.
We find time and time again through our survivors the resiliency that they demonstrate and actually ends up supporting our officers even more than we're able to support them.
Good evening, I'm Erica Fly. We begin with the latest on the loss of a Central Indiana deputy in the line of duty. The suspects in the death of Deputy Jacob Pickett are expected to face charges tomorrow, but today we're learning more about the man so many are now missing from their lives. Right now, his cruiser is on display in a tent just outside of the Boone County Jail. Hundreds of people have stopped by to show their support and leave tokens of their appreciation behind. Flowers, cards, and stuffed animals cover the area around the vehicle. Those who stopped by were overwhelmed by the impact of this crime.
It's very sad that in today's world that people find violence the only way to solve a problem and to take someone's life, anyone's life, but especially someone you don't know, and now his children and his wife and the whole community suffer because of it.
Almost hidden by all the other things that surrounded his vehicle was a card we spotted that said, "Our Hero." That description, a seemingly universal sentiment from all those